According to teachers, parents and leaders, the dilapidated school structures have been affecting learners, especially during rainy seasons.
Those P4, P5 would go to their good classes in the afternoon, but during morning hours it would be a problem. And when it rains, still they could come and join other learners. So it was the worst situation really.
But because of the poor infrastructure, one, the enrollment is very low. Two, the completion rate is very low, and also, and definitely this has no P7 when children complete P6.
With the name of improving school structures in Kamwenge District, government through the Ministry of Education and Sports has launched the construction of the long-awaited structures under the funding of school facility grants.
It means this is a great stride in as far as taking services nearer to the people, especially in the education sector. This is a service that directly impacts on the social services of the people.
The classroom blocks are going to be constructed at Kanyigaramire Primary School, Rugonjo Islamic School, Kanimi Primary School, Beranyanji Primary School, Bihanga Seed School, among others. The construction will cost 3.5 billion shillings for a period of 6 months.
We must make sure that it doesn't directly impact on the young ones. Because at the end of the day, you'll be punishing the innocent young who will eventually be left at home, not attending their education career.
Residents and local leaders hailed government for providing funds to construct the schools, saying most of the schools have been in a poor state. Relatedly, Kamuli District has launched a school's classroom renovation project at a cost of 7.51 billion shillings. The money is to be divided among its 11 schools.
It is constructing classrooms, fit latrines, teachers' houses, and providing furniture to a number of schools.
The funds will also facilitate the construction of staff quarters, VIP latrines, offices, stores, and procuring seats for both teachers and learners.
Mixing with one part of cement to three parts of sand during brick walling.
Waibi Joseph, the Kamoli District Education Officer, noted that construction has started.
And we are now calling upon all the people there, parents, local leaders, to make sure they follow up all the work being done, to make sure that the constructors are doing the right work.
The resident district commissioner, Rosemary Birungi, noted that the district is targeting to improve the education sector and service delivery.
So the contractors were awarded the contracts, and they are ready to commence. Some have already commenced, and we are moving to all those sites, handing the sites over to the contractors.
Report compiled by Anthony Atwini and Nathan Sengoba for the news.